Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can read an array from user, then how you can print its values on output screen, and how you can calculate its sum and how you can print that, right? So before starting the explanation, I just want to share one information. If you want to watch more programming related videos, so you can go to description of this video and you can find links of various playlists there. So now I'm going to implement the solution. So first I'm going to cover this part. I will tell you how we can read an array. So let's say we want 10 elements to be entered by the user. Then those will be printed back with our program on output screen and along with the sum. So starting from the beginning, first of all, I am declaring an array A10. So A is the name of array and 10 is the size. Then variable I and S equals to 0. So S will be containing the sum of array and I is for iterating reading and printing of array for loop purpose. So now I'm going to print a message: enter 10 numbers. So this message will be displayed on output screen. Now we need to read 10 numbers from user. So we have to implement scanf, but we are not going to write scanf 10 times. We are just repeating that scanf with the help of loop. So here I'm going to implement a loop which will repeat 10 times. And with this loop, I am going to repeat scanf statement 10 times. And inside scanf, you can see I am writing ampersand A of I. So ampersand A of I, so initially I is 0. So first it will read the value of 0 index, then 1 index, then 2 index, and so on. So loop is starting from 0 and it will end till 9. So 0 to 9 means 10 numbers. So all 10 different numbers will be stored inside array at different locations. And those locations we are identifying with the help of index, right? So here you can see I have not used any curly brace because for is repeating only one statement. So if we are repeating only one statement, then curly brace is optional. So this way, this process is complete. We are able to read an array from user. Now we need to print its values and we need to calculate its sum. So for that purpose, I am writing one more printf. So it will print the message you entered, right? And after this, I am writing one more loop. It will also repeat 10 times. This loop will also repeat 10 times. Now, inside this loop, I am going to print values of array. So I am going to print values of array. So here you can see now I am using printf. And this printf will print A of I. So I is initially 0. So first it will print the value which is available at 0 index, then 1 index, then 2 index, and so on. And so just after printing the value, I am going to add it into S variable. So first location value will be printed and immediately it will be added to S. Then second index value will be printed, it will be added to S. So this way all 10 values will be printed on output screen and they will be stored as sum into S variable. So after completion of this loop, I just need to print the value of S. So here I am writing one more statement. So this statement will print sum of array. This statement will print sum of array and then you can close the main function. So this way you can see this is the reading process. This is the reading process. Then here printing and calculate sum. Both are performing together, and here I am printing the calculated sum. So this way all three operations are performed. So we are able to read array, we are able to print its values, and we are able to print its sum. So this way I explained you how we can perform all three operations together with a C program. I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can open my channel, go to playlist, and you can watch various programming related videos. Thank you.